Welcome back to my project. This is Eric. When we start developing with ESP32, we have two options. They are Arduino framework, which is the easiest to access and use the most libraries, and ESP IDEA framework, which is officially supported by Aspersif. In fact, the relationship between these two is that Arduino framework wraps ESP IDEA in the form of a wrapper. It mainly simplifies the task and makes it follow Arduino's basic flow like a setup and loop function flow. Of course, it has a pros and cons. First, for beginners or simple hobby projects, it works perfectly well. It's easy to get started and lowers barriers to entry for using the microcontroller. And Arduino library is really diverse. Of course, you can use Arduino library with ESP IDEA, but some libraries don't work at all. But if you are serious about embedded development or want to develop more extensive ESP32 applications, I think it's more reasonable to use IDF. The new features are always released as IDF-based first. If your project is based on Arduino, you will have to wait until it's ported to Arduino to apply to use it. Also, if you need anything specific to ESP32 that Arduino libraries can do, you can always use IDF directly. Being able to work directly with IDF means you can actually understand the errors that occur when calling IDF functions. You can call IDF functions on the Arduino ESP32, but when debugging something, it's much easier to use IDF directly, familiar with the API references, and work directly with the source code than having to translate everything via wrapper functions. In addition, beyond the basic setup and loop functions of the Arduino framework, free RTOS-focused projects have component design patterns that allow functionality to be divided into smaller compartments, making large-scale projects much easier to organize. Actually, there is no right answer to this. You can use it according to the project you want to do. Just wanted to mention that if you decide to use ESP32 in your project, you need to seriously consider both options. In today's video, I prepared two versions of the same code. I'm trying to find out what different results are obtained when using IDEA framework and Arduino framework. Calculations, drawing screen, is there really a clear difference? I'm really curious. Let's test it. The device to be used in the first test is ESP32 S3 DevKit C1. This product has a flash 8MB and PSRAM 8MB. It's a very basic device, but I think it's a really great device. If you are a starter, this device will be a good choice. I found this code on Code Project, and the link can be found in the video description below. This is a benchmark to check the performance of floating point and integer arithmetic. Even if the MCU has a floating point unit, this kind of calculation is never easy. Also, since each calculation is performed 1 million times, it makes a lot of stress on the core. Let's start with Arduino IDE. Everything is default, only check CPU clock speed. It's set to 240 MHz. Let's build it right away and check the result. Oh, it's running much slower than expected. Let me speed up this. It's being calculated at a very, very slow rate. I did the same test on Arduino Portainta H7 before. If you compare it to the one on the right, you can see how slow it is. This test is not compared to Portainta H7, so let's skip this part. The important thing is the performance difference when calculating the same code based on the ESP IDEA build. This time, it's ESP IDEA. After the build, start the same test. CPU clock speed is the same 240 MHz. Also, the ESP version is 4.4.3. Seems it takes a lot of time. Let's compare the results right away. All calculations are done. The one on the left is built by Arduino framework, and the one on the right is built by ESP IDEA framework. In conclusion, ESP IDEA does not compute significantly faster. Both are calculated at similar operation rates. I was expecting a very distinct difference, but I couldn't confirm it with this test. What I'm going to test this time is the graphic drawing speed. Two identical devices have been prepared. They are WT32SC01 Plus with ESP32S3. The display module is ST7796, which is connected with an 8-bit parallel. Also, they use both LaFangGFX for the graphic library. All settings are the same here, only the framework is different. The results are very interesting. Arduino framework is showing better performance. I think I need to do more analysis on this to find the reason. At this point, I'm not sure why ESP-IDF has a slow performance. At least, I expected ESP-IDF to show faster or similar performance, but it wasn't. In the test I've done so far, ESP-IDF hasn't been significantly faster. It is true that IDF makes ESP32 more fully usable, but in terms of performance, it's not that overwhelming. In the end, I think the best way to proceed with the project is to do it the way you feel most comfortable. I will make a new video if there is an update. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.